Well, hello there. Kelly Baxter Fitzgerald here, independent maker with Close to My Heart, and I am excited to come on for a few minutes today and show you how to make this beautiful acetate window card. It is simple and yet elegant and so pretty. I'm excited to show you the coordinating cardstock from You Are Enough, which is, you've probably heard by now, the May National Scrapbooking Month special that will be debuting May and June, and it is a gorgeous, gorgeous line. But today we're only going to work with the coordinating cardstock. We're not even going to work with the whole beautiful paper suite, just that gorgeous coordinating cardstock. So in the coordinating cardstock pack, it has beautiful rose gold cardstock along with our regular cardstock that we already know and love. These flecks of rose gold were just so beautiful that I had to make a clear window so that you could see that beautiful rose gold pattern paper through it. So the You Are Enough has bundles and workshop kits and sticker sheets and thin cuts and bling and all kinds of things that come with it that are going to be debuted in May. But right now we're going to take a look at this rose gold foil cardstock in the coordinating cardstock pack and make beautiful cards just out of the cardstock. So there's all of these colors in the coordinating cardstock pack. We have bluebell, sapphire, peach, glacier, ballerina. Let's see, I think there's one more that I'm missing. Six different colors. Sangria. Yes, six different colors of rose gold coordinating cardstock. Some in a diamond pattern, some in rose gold flecks. And I'm in love with the fact that Close to My Heart has always been the company that has everything that coordinates and that you don't have to think about it. So we have coordinating inks for every one of our cardstocks. We have coordinating specialty papers that match up with our cardstock. So we're going to work today with our glitter paper, and I'm going to show you how adding a little bit of our beautiful glitter paper just makes the project pop. And we also have coordinating bling. So today we're working with sequins. We have bluebell sequins, gold sequins, and rose gold sequins that, added to any project, again, just gives it that little extra sparkle and shine. And I love just using these cardstocks or glitter papers: desert rose, bluebell, gold, ballerina, and sapphire. And they, you know, the camera doesn't do them justice. They just sparkle and shine. And I love to have a package of each of these glitter papers on hand just to pull at any given time and add just a little bit of that glitter paper to any project, and it just puts it over the top. It just makes it sparkle and shine and makes it seem so classy. I absolutely love it. These cards are simple, but with the shimmer and the shine to them, they're just beautiful. So we're going to put together those cards, and I'm going to show you how easy it is to make an acetate window card. And we're going to use a couple different things. Here are the You Are Enough layered butterfly thin cuts. Gorgeous. I use the small ones in this project, but you can also use the others for so many different things. I used one of our stitch borders to just give that top section a little bit of a decorative element. And then I used our acetate windows from our rectangle acetate and foam that we use for our shaker windows. And there are small, medium, and large acetate windows in one package of this, two of each, small, medium, and large. And I was able to cut those apart and get six acetate windows, plus have leftovers. So today we're going to create this acetate window card, and I love how it's going to show those You Are Enough coordinating cardstocks through it, and then you can put an uplifting sentiment on the back. So we're going to have a piece of cardstock 4x7 scored at 5.5, and we're actually using bluebell. So again, 4x7 scored at 5.5, and that's going to make that base piece that you're going to begin building that window on. And I could have made it 4 1/4, which is a standard card size, but I cut it down to 4 inches to get more bang for my buck. Then we're going to need 3 3/4 by 5 1/4 for the interior piece. And we're going to use the Bluebell Rose Gold coordinating cardstock from You Are Enough. Then we're going to use the Bluebell glitter paper, a 2x4 piece that is cut on the edge with any kind of decorative element that you want. And again, I used that scalloped stitched edge from our borders, our stitched borders. And I love that. I've used that. It's such a great investment set. Then we're going to need another 2x4 piece of cardstock for the bottom. And it's going to be a little longer than it needs to be because I want you to be able to trim it after adding the acetate window to get the most out of the window. Then we'll need 2 more strips of the Bluebell glitter paper. One will be 1/4 by 3 3/4 and one will be 1/4 by 4. One will be for the front and one will be for the back sentiment piece. And then of course for that sentiment piece, if you choose, that will be 3 3/4 by 5 1/4. Okay, and then we'll use a little Bluebell ink. We'll use some sponging with some sponges. We will use the You Are Enough stamp set that has those amazing sentiments that everyone needs to be uplifted. Of course, like I said before, we'll use the shaker window acetate to create those windows. And again, I'll get 6 windows out of 1 package of those. And there are 6 colors. So it worked out just perfect that I could make 1 window card out of each of those, out of 1 package of shaker window rectangles. So I'm going to cut the shaker window rectangles to 4 inches by 2 1/2. So you will cut the large rectangle window into 2 pieces of those, 2 that are 4 by 2 1/2, and then you will cut each of the medium-sized rectangles into 4 by 2 1/2, and you'll end up then with 6 rectangle windows. We're only going to use 1, of course, on the card today, but that will make the perfect peekaboo window that you can see that beautiful rose gold foil cardstock behind the window. Then, of course, we're going to, I created those, over those butterfly thin cuts, the solid on the Bluebell cardstock, and then the part that overlays on Bluebell glitter paper and vellum. Now, you can use that little butterfly out of the set, the You Are Enough stamp and thin cut set, or you can use the small butterflies out of the layered butterfly set. I opted to use the layered butterfly set, but both would work equally well and be equally as beautiful. Of course, liquid glass is your friend. You always need liquid glass for those little elements that you don't want to pop off when you put it in the envelope. And because we have butterfly wings and we have sequins, we want to use our amazing liquid glass to put that together. Okay, so what we're going to do is take some double-sided tape, some score tape that is 1/4 inch, and we're going to, some people call it tear tape, some people call it sukwang, some people call it score tape, some people call it double-sided tape, but whatever it is, it's super sturdy. And we want that window to be in place super sturdy, right? So we're going to put that on the edge of the scored piece, on the flap, the little flap that we created, and we're also going to put it on the top edge of the extra cardstock piece, and the window is going to be between those 2 pieces. So we're going to peel the film off of the acetate window, and sometimes if you just rub your fingernail along the more cloudy side, it will peel back that film really easily, and that film is just in place to keep that window from scratching. And then you're going to to line that window up just a quarter of an inch, which is the size of the score tape, and you're going to line it up on the left-hand side with just a quarter inch of it overlapping on top of that score tape. And that's going to be covered up by that decorative piece, but you've now created that cute window. Easy, huh? Now we're going to peel off the score tape of the extra piece of cardstock. You're going to line it up on the left-hand side and just cover a quarter of an inch of window that overlaps onto the cardstock piece. And that cardstock piece will overlap, but because you may not get it exactly straight, I wanted to give you a tiny bit of extra trim off just in case, so you don't run into trouble and make your piece a little too short. So then you can just put that on your paper trimmer and trim off the excess so that you're getting the most out of that window. You don't want to cover up too much of that window, just a quarter of an inch on top and a quarter of an inch on the bottom, and the hard part is done. You've created that window card. Now you're going to put the beautiful rose gold cardstock in, and you're going to put that in the center of the card so that the peekaboo window shows right through, and when the card is standing up, it will shimmer and shine and show through with that butterfly on the front. And then we're going to go ahead and add that decorative 2x4 scallop piece to the top, and I decided to do mine with foam tape. Now, you don't have to do it with foam tape, but we had some leftovers in the acetate window pieces that we had to already get, and so why not use those great foam pieces? I made sure to put them more toward the middle so that the foam wasn't peeking under the back on the acetate window. So just had it up a little farther, and it will secure really nicely with just those few pieces, and then you will have that nice little scalloped edge up there to just give it a finished look. Then you're going to use the 1/4 by 4 inch Bluebell glitter paper piece, and you're going to just cover that little score tape piece on the front and just make tie in those two decorative elements, the two shimmery elements. You can never have enough shimmer and shine, or too much shimmer and shine, in my opinion. Now we're going to put the layered butterfly together, and of course we're going to use our amazing liquid glass, just a tiny bit, a conservative amount of liquid glass in the center of the vellum butterfly, and adhere the vellum butterfly to the Bluebell base, and it never takes very long. Just wait a minute or so and let that set, and then you'll put a little more liquid glass on the center of the vellum piece, and you will attach the Bluebell glitter paper piece, and then you'll adhere those, and then you're going to let that set for just a little bit before you start bending the wings. Just let it get nice and set. It's like cement. It's great. So then for the sentiment piece, if you decide to do the sentiment piece on the back, of course you can say, "You are beautiful, you are strong, you are enough, you are brave, you are wonderful." And then I used the little flower vine from that set as well, and stamped that flower in intense black and colored it in with some ice gray tri-blend marker, and stamped the sentiment in Bluebell to coordinate with the Bluebell card. I did opt to use a sponge and some second generation Bluebell ink to be able to create a glow where you write your sentiment. So it just adds that finishing touch. I'm not going to do the stamping today just because I'm not on the proper surface for stamping. I would want my VersaMat for that. But I am going to rub off the majority of the Bluebell onto scrap paper, and second generation so lightly just rub on that sentiment piece so that when you write your uplifting note to whoever needs to hear that they are strong, beautiful, brave, and wonderful, and that they are enough, then it will have that nice little glow, and you can add that little glitter strip to it and your other little flower and your vine, and it will look so finished and so nice. So you're you're going to adhere that to the back and adhere the 3¾ by 1/4 inch strip of glitter paper on there just to add a finishing touch and tie it together. And then all that is left is to add your bling to the front. So again, we're going to use that handy dandy liquid glass. I spread my little butterfly wings out so they look dimensional and layered, and so that when you look at it at a glance, you're going to see a shimmery top with the light little vellum wings in between and then the color underneath. I really love this layered butterfly set from You Are Enough. And then I just adhered it right to the acetate window and spread the wings out just a little bit. And then taking my liquid glass and just making a little trail of tiny dots. And I love doing this. Just go ahead and make your little dots. It's easy to see what trail you would like. And then using those blue bell sequins, the loose sequins, and I love, again, just like the glitter paper, I love having a package of each of our sequins so that I can pull those out at any time and use those as bling. We have so many great colors. We have rose gold, we have bluebell, we have gold, we have silver, we have Christmas, we have so many amazing sequins, and just dropping one of those of varying sizes. And what's really neat is I used the bluebell sequins both on the bluebell card, window card, and the sapphire window card. And the sequins sort of take on whatever they're around, and it just fit perfectly for both of those. Same with the rose gold. I used the rose gold on the peach and on the ballerina card and turned out perfectly. So there you have it, an acetate window card with the You Are Enough coordinating cardstock. And remember, you are beautiful. Happy National Scrapbooking Month.